Have you ever wondered if the chemicals in your water really do evaporate off if you leave your water outside for 24 hours? Well, in this video, we're going to get into it. You're here with Mark Bowell at PerfectGardens.com. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe. And if you can, our Patreon button is down below. So if you have a few extra bucks, it's always helpful getting a few dollars donated to the channel. So let's go ahead and get into it. Jared Kushner and Bio Black. They both have actually similar questions or similar statements, and I wanted to reply back to them. Leaving water outside doesn't remove chloramine. And then also down here, Bob Black, chlorine and other chemicals evaporate out of sitting tap water. Simply air them out or air stone with a bucket for 24 hours before use. Okay, so for both of you guys are both correct, and you guys are both slightly wrong. And I'm going to actually show you some lab analysis showing you proof right now. All right. So if you guys have been part of the channel, then you probably have heard a product I always talk about. It's called dropsbalance.com. This is a phenomenal product. If you come to the website, shows a little video. This is stuff that actually comes out of your tap water, actually reverts man-made chemicals back to sulfated minerals. Basically just restructures your water, and they come in 2 ounce bottle all the way up to 32 ounce bottle. But if you come over here to safety and testing and scroll down, you'll even see chlorine, chloramine, fluoride, hexavalent chloramine. This is the Aaron Brockovich movie with the PG&E, and this is what got everyone sick. And VOCs, or volatile organic compounds. This is basically what leaches out of plastic bottles when they sit in the sun over time. And all you have to do is just by clicking this right here, it will take you to these lab analyses that I'm right about to show you. So the first one when I want to show you is the chloramine. So the chloramine, when you see right here, this is the controlled test. And if you let the water just sit outside, as you can see, over a course of 1 hour, 6 hours, 12, 24, 36, and 48, even after 48 hours, there is about 20% of the chemical still in the water after 48 hours. All right, if you use drops of balance, you can see after 48 hours, the chemical is completely inert. Okay, so it has completely reverted back the man-made chemical back to a sulfate mineral, and it got rid of it a lot faster. Like I said, you guys are both correct, because if you do let it sit, things will evaporate, chemicals will evaporate out of your water, although they don't evaporate as fast as you think. Bio Black. So how does this affect you? Well, if you are just letting the water sit outside for 24 hours, and at the 24-hour mark, it's still more than halfway just about of having the chemicals in your water. Well, over time, these salts and these chemicals will build up, and it will void your soil of bioavailability. So if you're growing with biodynamics, it's going to affect the communication between your microbiology and your plants, okay, and the whole soil food web system. So just kind of keep that in mind, that these chemicals actually don't evaporate away as fast as you think. And by feeding them to your soil and your plants will actually absorb these chemicals and end up getting stuck in your plants. So when you're using your end consumer product, you're actually going to be absorbing chemicals that are in your water over time. I wanted to show you some of the other lab analysis showing you that how powerful drops of balance is, because I know you could just say, well, look, it's just removing it a little bit faster, but it's more than that. So this is a chemical reduction test. As you can see right here, these are a whole bunch of different pesticides. And let me go ahead and zoom in a little bit more. These are a whole bunch of different pesticides. And this is what they added into the water, drops of balance with a little bit of filtration. This is 0.2 micron filter. As you can see, over a course of, I believe, 24 hours, yep, 24 hours, you can see how much of a reduction. So after 24 hours, it reduced these pesticides 79%, DDE 81%, DDT 81.3%, and all these other ones that I can't even mention, that you can see some of them getting as high as 99.9% on a reduction test. Getting rid of all these pesticides. These are what pesticides that regular farmers use to kill the bugs all over the world. As you can see, within 24 hours, drops of balance actually breaks these man-made chemicals down and reverts them back to man-made chemicals. If you added in at a ratio of 1 ml per gallon, that's what you want to give for plants, and you won't really see this. If you were doing it for your drinking water, you would actually see orange stuff begin to coagulate and fall out of solution or fall out of water after a course of 24 to 48 hours. So let's go ahead and go to the next one. This is a fluoride test, and a lot of people know about fluoride, same thing. After at drops of balance, 1 ml per liter, 2 ml per liter, 3 and 4. As you can see, this is how much goes into the controlled test. So at 1 ml per liter, it pretty much reverts about half of the fluoride. But at 4 ml per liter, it's completely undetectable. And that's fluoride. So it doesn't matter whether it's sodium fluoride or sodium fluoride silicate. Sodium fluoride is a byproduct of the aluminum industry, and sodium fluoride silicate is a byproduct of the fertilizer industry. So these are both reverting them back to sulfated minerals, which are naturally occurring sulfated minerals. These are VOCs, volatile organic compounds. When your plastic bottle sits outside in your hot car, it evaporates VOCs into that water, and the water absorbs the VOCs. So drops of balance can actually revert these man-made chemicals, volatile organic compounds, these VOCs, that can get absorbed in water and back to undetectable standards. That's huge. When you're getting rid of man-made chemicals out of your growing environment, then you literally just have the food you give your plants. You don't have all this excess crap that your plant basically has to defend itself from during the entire season because you're feeding your plants this crap that's in your water. Lead tests, undetectable, another 48 hours. And it continues to go on. This is the chromium 3, I believe. The chromium 6 is not the bad one. It's chromium 3. And this is the Aaron Brockovich movie where the PG&E basically poisoned that entire town. If you guys have never watched that movie, I highly recommend it, because they're still up to today cleaning that toxic spill, spending millions of dollars of taxpayer money. We are still paying for this problem. Us, yes, not PG&E anymore. Us, the taxpayers, are paying for the pollution of PG&E when they were dumping the chromium into the water system. And drops of balance completely reverts it back to the sulfated mineral and makes it undetectable. Anyways, I highly recommend this product for treating your water. Both of you guys were both correct, and both of you guys were slightly incorrect on your thought process just based upon time, and it does evaporate away, but not as fast as you think. Okay, I hope this video was helpful on understanding chemicals in your water. Please give me a thumbs up. And before we finish up this video, I do want to show you another video showing you how fast chlorine, which is just one of many chemicals, can absorb into your body. Although the reason why I'm showing it to you is so that you could realize how fast chlorine actually will absorb into your plants and kill your surface area of all your living bacteria and fungi.
This is an eye-opening demonstration of chemicals in your water. Unfiltered tap water, which we will pour in two glasses. OTO chemical, test for chlorine, very sensitive for it. 10 drops. Notice it turning yellow, the evidence of chlorine. No chlorine in this water. Where did that chemical go? While I was testing this glass over 10 seconds, all that chemistry went into my skin and my hands. The evidence is clear. There are 80,000 unstudied and unregulated chemicals in our tap water. This was a very simple and clear example of what happens when you simply take a shower or wash your hands. Those chemicals get absorbed quickly, readily, and completely into our skin, causing all sorts of health issues, from as simple as brittle hair and dry skin to respiratory issues and even cancer.